So we have created our custom Kismet event, and this event contains two output sockets, play and stop. The problem that faces us right now is that nothing ever activates those output sockets. If we were to drag and drop the Kismet event into the Kismet graph and connect it to some other nodes, nothing would ever happen. The play and the stop outputs would never be fired. That's because we have no code or functionality to activate them. What we want to do now is to create a function that will allow us to activate the specified output socket of the event. We want to create a function that will allow us to choose which output socket, either play or stop, we want to activate, we want to send an impulse to. I'm going to add this function to a new class, the second and the final class of our project. This class is going to be extended from the game info class. So I'm going to create that now, as before, by right-clicking on classes and selecting add a new item from the context menu. I want to make sure that I add an Unreal script file. I'm going to name this class My Custom Game Info and click the Add button here. Right now, the object extends from Object, which is the ultimate base class of all classes in Unreal Script. I don't want it to derive from that. I want to extend from the Game Info class. The function that I'm going to add to this class is going to be called activate event output, and it's going to take an integer parameter called index. This integer parameter index will specify to the function which output socket to activate. 0 will correspond to the play output socket, and 1 will correspond to the stop output socket. So if I call activate event output with the value of 0, this function will activate the play output socket of our event node. I'm going to add a few local variables to this function, and I'm going to explain what they do as we come to use those variables in the function. I'm just going to write them down here without giving further explanation, and I will detail them later. So I'm going to add the variable local sequence Kismet. I'm going to add another variable, array sequence object results. Going to add another local variable, int I, and another local variable, which is going to be an array of integers, and it's going to be called indices. Okay, so I have defined four different local variables here: Kismet, results, I, and indices. Now, we're going to think a bit here about what this function is going to do and how it's going to work. When this function is called, a value will be specified in index to indicate the output socket of the event node to be activated. But when this event is called, this function has no knowledge of the Kismet graph or any of the nodes in the graph, or even which event we're talking about. So the first thing this function needs to do is to get a reference to the Kismet graph associated with the level. That is, all of the Kismet nodes attached to the level. All of these nodes in this Kismet graph typically appear when we're using the UDK editor. When we click the K Kismet icon on the toolbar, it displays the Kismet graph with all of our nodes, the Matinee node, all of the event nodes. So we want to get a reference to all of those nodes attached to the level. Now, we're going to store that reference in the variable here, Kismet. So I'm going to get a reference to all of the Kismet of the level with this statement by saying Kismet equals weldinfo dot get game sequence. The function get game sequence returns a reference to all of the Kismet associated with the level. That reference is stored in the variable Kismet. The next thing that we want to do, once we've got a reference to all of the Kismet in the level, is we want to search through that graph and find all of the nodes that match our event node. We want to activate only the output connections on our event node. We don't want to activate the outputs of any other event. We don't want to activate the outputs of any other node in the graph. The only event we are interested in is the custom event that we have created. So we want to search the Kismet graph for all cases of our custom event. All cases of our custom event is going to be stored in the results variable here. We're going to search through the graph and find all my custom events and store them in this array of sequence objects here. So I'm going to type results. Oops, no, I'm not going to type that. I'm going to type Kismet dot find sequence object by class. Going to select that variable. Going to type the class that we're looking for, which is going to be my custom event. We're going to be looking for all nodes of the type my custom event. So this is our search criteria here. The next Boolean variable is called recursive, and this tells the function how it should search through the Kismet graph. We can search just at the top level of the graph, but the graph could also contain many subsequences or child sequences. So that is a sequence within a sequence. Do we want to search all of those child sequences as well? We should specify the value of true if we do. And the final parameter is the output. Where should the results of our search be stored? And they're going to be stored up here in the sequence object, the array of sequence objects results. This variable is going to contain a list of all the matching nodes in the graph. For our project, we happen to know in advance that our Kismet graph will contain only one instance of my custom event, but other projects might contain more. So we're going to choose results here. Once this function is called, the variable results will store all of the matching Kismet event nodes, all the my custom event nodes in our Kismet graph. I want to loop through all of those nodes by results.length. I want to loop through all of those nodes. And for each node, for each my custom event, I want to activate the output that's specified by index here. So I'm going to enter my custom event results I dot check activate. The check activate function is a function inherited from the sequence event object from which my custom event is derived. The check activate function is what allows us to activate a particular output of the Kismet event node. So I want to activate originator. I'm just going to specify world info in there. That's okay. I'm going to specify null for the second value. I want to specify false for the value of test. And for the final value, we don't need to worry about push top here, value here. That's an optional value. But we have an activate indices variable here, which is an array. Now, this variable is an array of integer values. And really, in our case, we're only interested in the first element in this array. What this first element in the array will do is tell the function which output socket to activate. Now, if I just press the escape key a second and I just insert a new line here, and I use this indices variable here, let's just copy and paste it into here, and I want to set the first element in the array to the parameter index, like so, and then I want to pass this to the checkActivate function as the final parameter. Index 0, the first element in the array, will equal the index parameter here. So indices 0 equals index. The index parameter indicates the output socket to activate. So in our case, it will be either 0 or 1. So this first element in the array will equal either 0 or 1 and specifies which output socket to activate. And we pass that value to myCustomEvent. And that is all that is involved in activating our output socket. We have a function now that can activate the specified output socket of an event. However, our work does not end here. There's still a bit more to do, and we shall see what that is very shortly.